And scholars, as promised, a concluding speech. In this concluding speech, first we must have emotionally appropriate music. That will do. We begin, as always, by thanking a group of individuals that we could never thank enough. Those are the teachers and leaders of the World Scars community. They are those who bring us here. They face our greatest fears and mentor us when we are challenged by what we are learning. They make sure we are safe at night. They make sure we are safe during the day too. Sometimes they may fall through the floor of the fair, but even in those moments, we know that they are taking care of you, that they believe in the mission of the program, which is that we can all learn together. Behind the teachers of this program, behind all of us, behind me right here, are our families. Our families give us everything in this life. They get us started, they keep us going. They're there for us when we get home from events like this one. Sometimes they will count our medals and say, congratulations. Other times they'll count our medals and say, why did you not win more? But either way, I guarantee you this, every one of your families is incredibly proud of all that you do. They understand us and they support us. Others who may not understand us as much but support us very much are the schools of the World Scholars Cup. Without them, you would not be the incredible students that you are. You would not be here with us, bringing so much learning to this event. And all around the world, there are special host schools. We call them hosts, but they are more than that. They are partners in opening doors to this community all over the world. Please put your hands together for the host schools of the World Scholars Cup. Here in Manila, of course, we had two debate schools, of which you only visited one, but both of them were so hospitable. They stepped forward when this round grew from a projected 600 scholars to 1,500 to find more classrooms and limitless hospitality. We thank De La Salle Zobel and also the home of Richard Southville International School. And all this week, we as a team at the World Scholars Cup, we flew in here, right? We came from far away. But there was a group of individuals here, former scholars of the Philippines, who when they heard there would be a global round in the Philippines, immediately messaged us again and again until we finally answered. I'm so sorry it took us so long, because they wanted to volunteer and they have done so much to make this event work. They came here, they've done the thankless jobs, you might call them the dirty jobs, but we know from our studies this year that these are the indispensable jobs, and these volunteers deserve every bit of applause that we can give them. There are others who are not here today. Sometimes they wear dinosaur suits, sometimes they arrange the medals, but they are always here for you. And we are grateful that they were here for us. Thank you all so much. Please do remain on stage. Of course, there are others we must thank that were very special and specific to this round. This was the first ever round ever to be joined by Dead Dave. We thank Dead Dave not just for his service, but for his great attention and support during the Scholars Show. Many of you may have seen that in the picture-in-picture, he was gazing with great respect upon the performers as the smoke billowed around him, looking a bit like tear gas. Scholars, we must also give special thanks to the dead helicopter in the picture. We had hoped they would fly and deliver medals, but it did not. Rufus, our amazing photographer, will be taking the helicopter home to be repaired. He will give it to his son and hopefully bring it back to Durban, where it will help keep us safe and happy. Speaking of keeping us safe and happy, scholars, we must give special thanks to the security team at the Marriott entrance. By now, we know many of them, and they know many of us. They have searched 10,000 bags and seen thousands of Jerrys. They are incredibly patient, and they are very attentive to detail, except when they see Taryn, who for whatever reason they let go through, maybe it is the green tea. Taryn is not as harmless as you think. He controls the helicopters. And scholars, we must give extra special thanks to something that we have not given enough respect to this week. Something that some of us have tried to avoid. Scholars, we must thank the outside.
No, we don't.
The outside has been out there waiting for us this entire week. Sometimes it has been rainy, sometimes it has been sunny, but it has always been outside, no matter what we say about it. Maybe next year we will love the outside. And scholars, at this point in the ceremony, it is only right that we announce the winners of the inside challenge. Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb. Winning the silver medal in the inside challenge, representing South Dakota, Singapore, and Qatar Airways is Mr. Joseph Har. And for your prize, in addition to the silver medal, we have in the egg chair for you. A special doormat. This can be used to insulate you from the outside, but only for up to 4 seconds.
It's a cool place. I thought it was 6 seconds, but nonetheless, I will travel with this so that next time I can be the overall champion.
Joga, if it were 6 seconds, you wouldn't have been in silver position. 4 seconds max. And winning the gold medal in the inside challenge. Who is it, scholars? Representing the Lone Star Republic of Texas, Mr. Robert Brown.
It will be 10 days and 3 hours until I've gone outside. I'm ashamed.
Robert, do you feel like you're noticeably paler than you were at the beginning of the week? Let us compare you to the color of Dead Dave.
I protest this result.
We don't take protests. We just read your emails and ignore them. You're still somewhat lit. And scholars, with the winners of the Inside Challenge announced, which is more than I can say about the winners of the Scholar Scavenge, which we never announce, we move on to give special thanks to a group of individuals that came in the night before this event began, because we fired the previous group of individuals who were not doing so well with what they were supposed to do. And that means that we must thank the incredible AV team here. These individuals, led by Roberto and his friends, have genuinely become part of our team. They have been positioning the alpacas to get good video where the alpacas are on screen. Backstage, you have not seen this, but they literally have Jerrys that they have decorated with sunglasses and microphones on their heads, because they have bought into the same quirky spirit as all of us. It is a priceless thing to get to work with others who understand that we can have fun even in a serious setting. And speaking of having fun in a serious setting, there is a group of individuals who know how to do that, because we have to do it all year long. This journey, this community, could not exist if not for this incredible World Scars Cup team that has come together over the years, that is upon this stage, and of course the others who are currently hiding at university. And scholars, a lot happens at each global round, it is true, and throughout the season, but sometimes we don't think about those who are working in all of them at once. In fact, I think there might be one person who did more than anyone else for all the global rounds put together.
I wonder how we could figure that out. Maybe with a series of rapid-fire questions like in the opening ceremony?
That could work. Maybe six questions would be
the trick. When we finish, everyone will know who it is.
All right, let's try it. When you're renting a convention center, who do you think?
Vishal. When you need to venture, who you think?
Vishal.
When you're recruiting in India?
Vishal.
Vishal. When you're selecting an Indian flag bearer?
Vishal.
When you need a friend to talk to?
Vishal.
When you need a cultural dance?
Vishal.
Well, I guess it's clear. Vishal is the staff member who we need to be thanking. Joga.
I think so.
Will you climb Vishal?
You know what, scholars? I think I have only one choice. I will climb Vishal.
Climb Vishal.
Climb Vishal.
Climb Vishal.
Climb Vishal.
Climb Vishal.
Scholars, in the week ahead, we have broken all the chairs. In traffic to debate, go to the ball and to the fair. And at the end, we look back at the time that we had shared.
And we thank our beds,
and we'll thank the doors.
And we thank our friends,
and we'll thank them more.
And we'll thank Vishal.
Vishal, any words? Speech music.
Kind of speechless right now, but we did it, team. It would have not been possible to organize this not so many global round without the support of our incredible team over here. And I'm just a representative of this team, and I love this team so much. Thank you. Thank you for your honor. Thank you for being there for me. Thank you.
We love you too, Dad. He's everyone's dad. Everyone say thank you, Dad. And we promise you can skip Durban if you want. And all of us are united here upon this stage in gratitude to those without whom this program would have no life, no spirit, and no story. We are so grateful to you, the scholars of the World Scholars Cup. This ceremony could not have been what it was without the incredible hard work of an individual who literally was having nightmares about this new responsibility that had fallen upon him in the absence of KK, our DJ, Mr. Alad Lines. Scholars, one more time for Alad. Climb the Alad. Never mind. And all that remains now is to announce our overall champion teams and the additional qualifiers at the end. In 20th place in the senior division, we welcome from Southville International School, Team 559. In 19th place, from Malaysia's College Yayasan, we made Logan sad by taking his passport, Team 486. In 18th place, from our debate host school for the senior division, De La Salle, Santiago, Zobel, Team 611. in 17th place. It is a mixed team from China, a team that covers both its bases, Team 414. In 16th place, from the Philippines, it is Miriam College, New Valley, Team 542. In 15th place, from California, St. John Bosco High School, something you can post about tonight, Team 599. The last resource will be out soon. In 14th place in the senior division, from Toronto, Alexander McKenzie High School, Team 413. In 13th place, it is Dara International School, Team 584. They're also the school most closely located to an IKEA. In 12th place in the senior division, from Tokyo Metropolitan Kokusai High School, we welcome Team 481. A team we know has not gotten much sleep while studying. In 11th place, from India, from Vidya Shilp Academy, Team 455. In 10th place in the senior division, from the Philippines, from Grace Christian College, Team 532. In 9th place in the senior division, it is a mixed team from Indonesia, Team 473. In 8th place, from Indonesia, SMA Lab School, Kepadaran 476. In 7th, from Southville, Team 564. In 6th place, from Vietnam, a mixed team, Team 602. In 5th place, from Grace Christian College, Team 533. In 4th place, from the Philippines once again, from Miriam College High School, Team 537. In 3rd place, at this most competitive ever not so mini global round in the history of the World Scholars Cup, this team is from Taiwan, from the International Bilingual School at Hsinchu Science Park. It is Team 581. And your second place team in the entire senior division. This team joins us from what country? Or perhaps I should say what place to avoid saying something politically incorrect. This team is from Canada, from Alexander McKenzie High School, Team 412. And winning first place, the overall champion team in the senior division. This team is from the quote unquote beautiful island of Taiwan! From the International Bilingual School at Hsinchu Science Park, it is Team 576, Caitlin Chen, Joshua Zhao, and Janet Chen Jiang. Scholars, one more time for our overall champion team. here at the Manila Not So Mini Global Round. And for some reason, a bottle of Tabasco sauce just appeared at my feet. Medics are available outside. Did we really hit Janet with Tabasco sauce as she won? Well, that might actually be a good moment to transition to our final In Memoriam of the evening, for which perhaps Sad Havana would be appropriate. Scholars, before we announce the additional qualifiers, let us take one last moment to honor those of our team who are not present. Scholars, as this ceremony comes to a close, so does the gap year of our beloved friend, Mr. Robert Brown. We'll miss you, Robert. Come back soon. Panama round? TOC? Speaking of TOC, let's find out who else has qualified. Take note, these additional bye, Dave. He rode off into the sunset on a dead horse, or the dead horse rode off on him. Bye, Robert. And now our additional qualifiers who will see Robert at the Tournament of Champions as he will skip his midterms. These teams qualify only for the Open Senior Division. They do not qualify for the Junior Division because that is full. And now, scholars, we will ask you to say a sort of nonsense word that may or may not mean something that will make us all feel happy together.
Scholars, can you pois with us on three? One, two, three! One, two, three! One, two, three!
And one last chair. One, two, three, chair! Scholars, we love you so much. We'll see you soon at the Tournament of Champions or next season, wherever our paths may cross.
Oh, don't you dare look back. Just keep your eyes on me. I said you're holding back. She said, shut up and dance with me. This war. wasted.